Thanks, Sarah. So, I don't want to include the easy mode of my game in Master, since I still want the official version of the game to be the standard difficulty. But I do want to include all the latest changes from Master in the easy mode branch. To do this, I'll first check out the easy mode branch, so the easy mode will update whenever I make changes. Then I'll run git merge master easy mode. Now git alerts me there was a merge conflict in game.js. This means that both branches, master and easy mode, changed the same part of game.js. Just like when Rachel and Jake both modified the same line, git can't know which changes to keep, so I'll have to resolve the conflicts. To resolve the conflict, I need to open game.js and find where the conflict occurred. Now git represents conflicts using these special lines, so I can always find it by searching for a bunch of less than signs in a row. If I scroll down, I can see that these lines divide the screen into three sections. 1, 2, 3. The top section, marked head, is my code. The bottom section, marked master, is the code that's in master right now. And the middle section is the original version that both branches modified, which git calls the common ancestor. Now when I'm trying to resolve a merge conflict, the first thing I do is try to understand what changes both branches have made. The difference between the middle section and the top shows the changes that I made in the easy mode branch. If I've forgotten what those changes were, I can spend a few minutes comparing and recall that the difference was changing this 3 to a 2. The difference between the middle and the bottom shows the changes that were made in master, and it happens that this particular change was made by Sarah. It's pretty common when I'm resolving merge conflicts that one set of changes will be made by me and the other by someone else. So I might need to go talk to that person, but first I always try to understand what they were doing by looking at the changes they made. Here, it looks like Sarah replaced this entire section of code with a call to a function called break into fragments. Now that probably means that she created this function and moved this code into that function, which is a pretty common way to make code more readable by breaking it up into understandable parts. Now I need to find this function that she wrote to see if she just moved the code over or if she also changed something. I could search for it, but in this case it turns out that it's right up here. Now it might look like this function existed in both versions, since it's not inside the special merge conflict lines, but actually that's just because this change didn't create a conflict. Now after I spent a few minutes comparing this function to the code that was removed by Sarah below, I could see that she didn't make any changes to the code other than to move it. Now how should I resolve this merge conflict? On the next screen, rewrite the code to what you think the final version should be. Make sure to remove all of these special lines. For example, if I wanted to undo my changes, I could just delete my version and the original version, as well as these special lines, to leave only Sarah's code. Instead, you should create a version of the code that incorporates both of our changes.